Hello everyone, welcome to Plant Science Channel. I am Likita Reddy here. In this video, we'll be discussing about external structure or else morphology of pinus. Now that pinus belongs to the division gymnosperms because it is showing a fundamental character that is nothing but a presence of naked seed. Moving on to the further classification, it belongs to the class Coniferopsida. Why it is belongs to the class Coniferopsida means here it is expressing the characteristics like evergreen tree, branched tree and presence of scaly leaves. And remember, here the leaves are adopted for the xerophytic condition, and it belongs to the order Coniferalis by showing the characteristics like a dimorphic branch, which means it is representing the two forms of branches and presence of needle like leaves and resin canals. And it belongs to the family Pinaceae by showing the characteristics like monoecious needle-like leaves and the presence of winged pollen grains. Remember, here in the Pinaceae family, you can see the winged pollen grains, and it belongs to the genus Pinus. And moving on to the distribution, throughout the world, you can see the presence of more than 105 species, and these are present towards the northern hemisphere. And these species will form the dense evergreen forest. And like, I think you might have got a question that why these plants are mainly present in the northern hemisphere, because here these plants will grow better in the colder weather and in the acidic soils, so that's why they are present in the northern hemispheres. And coming down to the distribution in India, you can see the presence of 5 species. And in some textbooks, they have mentioned 5 to 6 species. So you can see it is about 5 species, and mainly you can see in the northeast and northwest Himalayas. So here the northeast and northwest Himalayas will be like, these are called as the northeast Himalayas, where, these are the northwest Himalayas, where you can see the Jharkhand, Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir. You can see the northeast, northwest Himalayas in the Jammu Kashmir, Ladakh and Himachal Pradesh. And northeast Himalayas are present in Arunachal Pradesh, here, Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim, Mizoram and Nagaland. So this is about the distribution. Throughout the world, you can see about 105 species are present. Mainly these are present towards the northern hemisphere, and these species together form a dense evergreen forest. So this pine forest will be forming a alpine forest, you know. And coming down to the distribution of India, it is represented by the 5 species. You can see in the northeast and northwest Himalayas, the northwest Himalayas like Jammu Kashmir, Ladakh, Himachal Pradesh, and northeast Himalayas region like Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Sikkim, Nagaland, Tripura, etc. And the different types of species which are present in India are Pinus rosiber, Pinus valisinia, Pinus giradiana, Pinus marcusi, and Pinus insularia. So these are the species which are found in the northeast and northwest Himalayan regions of India. And next, coming down to the morphological features or as the external characters, the plant body is represented by sporophytic, or else we can say you can see the sporophytic plant body, and this is evergreen tall trees. And plants are adopted for the xerophytic habitats. And another thing here, you can see the plant in a pyramidal appearance. So the plant will be of a pyramidal appearance. And these plants are majorly adopted for the xerophytic habitats. And the plant body has got differentiated into root, stem and leaves. Yeah, learning about roots. Here, the roots are of typically taproot. And remember, the taproot which is present, that does not. Here, you can see the taproot that does not penetrate deeper into the soil. But the lateral roots which are present there, they will be helping for the holding of the roots to the soil. So, lateral roots will help for the holding to the soil surface, while the deep taproot will not deeply penetrate into the soil. And another major important characteristic of the roots are nothing but the presence of mycorrhizal roots. So what are mycorrhizal roots means? Here the roots are covered with the fungal hyphae, and here these type of roots will show the symbiotic association. So I think you might have known what is symbiotic association. Both the partners will get benefited, right? So here how the fungus and plant is getting benefited means plant is providing the fungus the carbohydrates. So here the carbohydrates are provided by the plant to the fungus, which is helpful for the growth of fungi. While the accumulation of fungus increases the root, surface area of the root, and it will enhance the water and nutrition uptake. Yeah, next comes to the stem. Here the stem is cylindrical, erect, woody and branched. And coming down to the branches, the branches are monopodial and dimorphic. I have not included that monopodial in this slide. Note it down. The branches are monopodial. Monopodial branches are nothing but these are growing. These are the branches which are growing upward with a single main stem or axis. So they'll be growing upward with a single main stem or else the axis. That's why they are showing a pyramidal appearance. You can take example of Ashoka tree. Or else if you take an example of hibiscus, that won't show a monopodial branching. That is not showing a monopodial branching. Here the pinus trees will be showing a monopodial branching, and the branches are of dimorphic. So here the term comes dimorphic. So what do you mean by dimorphic means? Here the branches are representing in two distinct forms. Or else we can say if any animal is representing in our two distinct forms, we can tell that is of dimorphic. For example, we humans are dimorphic in nature. How? Sexually we are dimorphic in nature. How means? Here you can see we are the humans, but males are different from the females. So single form or else single organism representing our two distinct forms will be calling that as a dimorphic. But here when it comes to the pinus, the branches are dimorphic, which means the branches will be showing or else will be represented in a two distinct forms. So in that, the first one is of long shoot, or else we can call that as a branches of unlimited growth. Long shoots or else the branches of unlimited growth, and second one is dwarf shoots or branches with limited growth. Coming down to moving on to the long shoot or branches of unlimited growth. Here these are present on the main trunk. So this is a main trunk. These are present on the main trunk, and you can see here in the branches of unlimited growth or as the long shoots, you can see the presence of apical buds. That's why it grows indefinitely. I think you might have known the apical buds. Apical buds are also known as the terminal buds. We can define apical buds as the growing points located at the apex of the stem. So apical buds or as the terminal buds are nothing but growing points which are located at the apex of the stem, apex of the tip of the stem. So here in the apical buds, you can see the continuous cell division and continuous growth. So that's why these branches will grow indefinitely. Got it? Then here in this type of branches, those are nothing but a long shoot or else the branches of unlimited growth, you can see the presence of scaly leaves. In this image, it is not clear to show scaly leaves. In the further slides, I'll show you the scaly leaves. So remember, the long shoots will be producing or else will be developing the scaly leaves, and we will be having the presence of apical buds. And next comes to the dwarf shoots or as the branches with limited growth. So here the main difference between long shoots and dwarf shoots, a presence of apical bud. Apical bud are present in the long shoots while the apical bud is absent in the dwarf shoots. So that's why you can see the limited growth. And here these will develop a scaly leaves along with the foliose leaves. So here dwarf shoots will produce both the scaly leaves and the foliose leaves. And you can see other character, one important characteristic in the dwarf leaves, dwarf shoot, that is nothing but the branchioblast. That is nothing but a branchioblast. Brachyplast. BRACHYBLAST. So here the brachyplast is nothing but the leaves are crowded at a place. So if the leaves are crowded, we can call that as a brachyplast. You can see here the leaves are crowded at a place, at a particular reason, we can call that as a brachyplast. And other important character of dwarf shoot, here the dwarf shoot shed once in every 2 to 3 years. So the dwarf shoots shed once in every 2 to 3 years. Yeah, moving further to leaves, here the leaves are dimorphic in nature. In previous slide I have already told what is dimorphic, representing two distinct forms. So here you can see two types of leaves are present in this plant. One form is of scaly leaves, another one is of foliose leaves. So scaly leaves are dark brown, membranous, thin and small. Small leaves which are present on both type of shoots. So these are dark brown, membranous, which is covered with a thick layer of cuticle, and thin. You can see the presence of the scaly leaves both shoots, like both on the long shoot and the dwarf shoots. And here they won't perform help in the process of photosynthesis. Why? Because these leaves are lacking the chlorophylls, or as chloroplast. So the chloroplasts are absent in the scale. The chloroplast is absent in the scaly leaves, and the main function of the scaly leaves to protect the young buds. And here the scaly leaves are present only on the dwarf shoot, only, so they are present both in the dwarf shoot and the long shoots. And here the term comes, the cataphylls. The cataphylls can be defined as, these are the scaly leaves which are present on the dwarf shoot with a distinct midrib. Those are nothing but the cataphylls. So the definition of cataphylls, the scaly leaves which are present on dwarf shoot with distinct midribs, we can call that as a cataphylls. And here they fall as the branch get mature. So once the branch get matures, they'll fall off. And here you have to remember the term cataphylls. The scaly leaves which are present on dwarf shoot with distinct midrib are called as a cataphylls. That this may be asked for in your for the one mark question. And next form of the leaves, that is nothing but the foliose leaves. So here the foliose leaves are green and needle-like leaves, which are borne only on the dwarf shoot. So where you can see the scaly leaves, you can see the scaly leaves both on the dwarf shoot and the long shoot. While the foliose leaves, here you can see the foliose leaves only on the dwarf shoot. And the function of the foliose leaves is to perform the activity of photosynthesis, and they'll remain persistent. What it means, they'll be present throughout the life cycle of that plant. So the function to perform the activity of photosynthesis, and important, they'll remain persistent throughout the life cycle of the plant. And here, why they are needle-like in appearance, why these foliage leaves are needle-like, means here they'll be adopted for the xerophytic condition. And here the term comes, the foliospur. Foliospur is nothing but the group of needle-like leaves, or else the group of needle-like foliage leaves which are present on the dwarf shoot. So the group of needle-like foliose leaves which are present on a dwarf shoot will be calling that as a foliospur. While the cataphylls, these are the scaly leaves which are present on the dwarf shoot with distinct midrib. Foliospur, group of needle-like foliose leaves which are present on the dwarf shoot. So here, this is of a long shoot, while this is of dwarf shoot, and this is a foliar spur. Foliar spur, here the group of needle-like leaves which are present on the dwarf shoot. And next comes to the cataphylls. Here we can't explain the cataphylls. It is not visible. The cataphylls are not visible. Cataphylls, the scaly-like leaves Sorry, the scaly leaves which are present on the dwarf shoot, which means this is a dwarf shoot. On this, you can see the presence of scaly leaves with a distinct midrib. Understood? So, here you can see a clear picture of a shoot of a branch of a branch of Pinus. This is of long shoot. This is of a dwarf shoot and which is covered by a scaly leaves. Getting it now? Long shoot, dwarf shoot covered with the scaly leaves with a distinct midrib, we'll be calling these as a cataphylls, and it is a foliar spur, group of needle-like leaves which are present in a foliar which are present on a dwarf shoot. So this is about the external structure or as a morphology of Pinus. Thank you.